Captain Kenway, just in time.
One more for the collection. Thank you.
Captain. Captain has the helm.
What news are they?
This Bajon works for the Royal African Company. Tell him what you told me.
I haven't seen the princess for 8 weeks or more, meaning she may soon be back.
What else?
I thought this Buck belonged to the other men who was asking about the princess this morning. So I told him that...
What other men?
Haughty sailor in plain rags, and a gent with a scar just here.
Where have they got to?
Staying just round the corner, they said.
I grow tired of chasing these fantasies of yours, Edward. As does the crew.
Hang in there, man. We're getting close.
Sweetheart. got a deadline!
I got a shot! No!
Shrubs! You're not that quick!
Through your teeth soon.
Teach them fear!
Give them no quarter! Show them suffering!
You're in my sight, sweetheart!
We're short on time.
Aye. There'll be two soldiers waiting for us at the crossroads.
Very good.
If you don't mind me asking, sir, what's the meaning behind these blood samples you're taking?
Torres tells me that blood is required for the observatory to properly function.
How do you mean, sir?
If one wishes to use the observatory to, say, spy on King George, then one would require a drop of the king's blood to do so. In other words, a small sample of blood gives us access to a man's everyday life.
Does Torres mean to spy on me, then? For I've just given him a sample of my blood.
As have I, Captain Hornigold. As will all Templars. It is a measure of insurance.
And trust, I reckon.
Yes, but fear not. Torres has shipped our samples to a Templar safe house in Rio de Janeiro. We will not be the observatory's first subjects, I assure you.
Aye, sir. I suppose it's a small price to pay for what the Templars have given me in return.
Precisely.
Governor, when you hunted pirates in Madagascar, what methods worked best?
I believe it was my charisma that persuaded them. Violence and threats should always be a last resort. In Madagascar, I offered those pirates a choice. Take a pardon and return to England penniless but free men, or be hanged by the neck until dead.
Just as you did in Nassau.
Precisely. A pity Commodore Chamberlain did not live to see my thorough success.
It's not like you to gloat, Rogers.
We all deserve a moment, don't we?
A cargo of pelts, as usual. They're paying quite well still. My big concern is to find lots of power.
Grandmaster, welcome.
Buenas noches. Whatever you mean.
The princess was taken by pirates 6 weeks ago. And so far as we know, the sage Robert is still aboard.
Very good.
And what measures are you taking to recover the princess from this pirate?
Captain Hornigold has dispatched some of his best men to ensure the sage is captured.
What of the sage's present location?
Africa, Your Excellency.
Africa? By God. The winds do not favor them.
I concur, Grandmaster. I should have sailed there myself. One of my slave galleys would be more than capable of making a swift journey.
Slave galley? Captain, I ask you. Taking to recover the princess from this pirate.
Captain Hornigold has dispatched some of his best men to ensure the safe capture.
What measures are we taking to recover the princess from this pirate?
Captain Hornigold has dispatched some of his best men to ensure the sage is captured.
What of the sage's present location?
Africa, Your Excellency.
Africa? By God,
I concur, Grandmaster. I should have sailed there myself. One of my slave galleys would be more than capable of making a swift journey.
Slave galley? Captain, I asked you to divest yourself of that seeking solution.
I failed to see the difference between enslaving some men and all of them. Our aim is to steer the entire course of civilization, is it not?
A body enslaved inspires the mind to rule. But enslave a man's mind, and his body will follow him. Natural and efficient.
Hold you!
A fair point.
Remind me, where in Africa are we looking?
Principe, sir, a small island.
We've sent two of our best men, Burgess and Cochrane. Privateers with fast ships and firm hearts.
Edward Kenway! Imagine my surprise at seeing your jackdaw anchored there. Have you heard all you came to hear? Will you now rescue the sage from our clutching hands?
A pox on you, traitor! You sold us downriver.
Because I found a better path. The Templars know order, discipline, structure. But you never could fathom these subtleties. Goodbye, old friend. You were a soldier once, when you fought for something real. Something beyond yourself.
Captain has the helm.
Heave up all evil way, way, hey, oh. the hump back!
What's our course, Captain?
Bridger Bay, quartermaster. We're sailing for the coast of Africa.
The royals and tops!
Furl the mizzen tops!
Enemy sails! More!
Off the wind!
Surely we are nearing our goal.
Cliff ahead!
Clue up! Clue up!
I'm off to find Roberts.
Don't stay long. Crew's getting restless out there.
Captain Kenway.
Yet another dire situation, Roberts. We really must stop meeting like this.
Stop tailing me and your wish had come true.
There's no need for this. You know I'm as good as my word.
Our Captain Howell was killed today in a Portuguese ambush. Headstrong fool. I warned him not to go ashore.
It was orchestrated by the Templars, Burgess and Cockrum. The same sort that took you to Havana.
Ah, I see now there is no escaping the Templars' attention, is there? I suppose it is time to fight back.
I do like the sound of that.
And I know just how I'll do it. But these men, Burgess and Cockrum, they cannot be allowed to leave with word of my escape.
They won't. Count on it.
If you spot any men from my crew, do them some kindness and send them here.
I'll do all I can.
The tiger! There's only what you can carry, maggot.
We're not waiting on no one.
You did us good, Kenway. Proved yourself a true bravo. And for what?
His own bloody pride.
You stepped in the path of my prize. Not a thing a man should do.
A cocksure, Cully. Just like Hornigold said.
That Templar scab means nothing to me. None of you do.
And you're worse for it, Kenway. It were the Templars who took us in when all else went to shit. Not our king. Not our country. The Templars.
The Templars is our family. Where's yours?
In honest service, there are thin commons. No wages. Yet, as gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. So what man with a sensible would choose the former life, when the only avenue I can is a sour look from those without respect or pleasure? Frightened to see your passions reflected from me in so stark a light. But if it's a captain you see in me now, why then, I'll be a ready captain. Yeah! For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man. Yeah! Oh. You fatten with your assistance.
I'm looking for the observatory. Folks say you're the only man that can find it.
Folks are correct. Despite my distaste for your eagerness, I see in you a touch of untested genius. I'm Bartholomew Roberts.
Edward.
I've no secrets to share with you now. But if you'll lend me your aid, in 2 months' time, west of the Leeward Islands. Well, it's there you'll get some answers, I promise you.
Funny that. With scurvy, the fix is more pleasant than the cause. When you catch a dose from a horn, must treat it with quicksilver. You're fonder of getting the disease than you are of curing it. Something biting at you.
Oh, all men desire to live by a code or a creed, yes? Yet when pressed, most defer to their instincts rather than the laws that bind them. What is the appeal of a creed if it does not yoke all men to like behavior?
Might make a man feel like he belongs to something. What's your answer?
Oh, that all men are sheep. That an old wolf like me deserves every ounce of blood he draws. Sail to this location. Bring only those you trust.